available street food of India. Ghugni is made with dried yellow or white peas. Peas are soaked, boiled and cooked with tomatoes and spices. So let's go ahead to learn how to make this yummy Ghugni Chaat. I have taken 2 cups of soaked yellow peas, then add 2 cups of water, then add 1 teaspoon of salt, then add 1 small onion cut into big chunks. Now just put a lid on and let it give 2 to 3 whistles. If you are not using pressure cooker, then it will take lots of time to boil these peas. 3 whistle complete and put the power off and let it cool. Hope my peas are cooked well. After completely pressure gone, now just open the lid and check the yellow peas. If they are not cooking well, then again give 1 or 2 whistles. In a pan, add 2 to 3 spoon of cooking oil, then add 1 stick of cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1 teaspoon of crushed ginger and garlic, then 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, then give it a stir. Now let them cook for 30 seconds. Yes, they are perfect. Now I'm adding 1 small sized tomato cut into big chunk, and then add 1/4 teaspoon of salt. And don't add too much salt because we have already added 1 teaspoon of salt into the boiling peas. Give it a stir and just put the cover and let it cook 1 or 2 minutes over medium heat. And you can stir in between. Now open the lid and again give it a stir and just break the uncooked tomatoes. My tomatoes are almost cooked and looks good. You can use tomato puree also. Now I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of coriander powder, and again give it a stir. Red chili powder gives nice color and the heat. And here I am adding 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala and again give it a stir. You can add the garam masala at the last. Yes, my ghugni will be very yummy. Now I am adding 1/4 teaspoon of sugar and give it a stir. Once the sugar caramelizes, then it gives very nice color. Now add the cooked yellow peas into the tomato gravy and give it a stir and put the cover and let it cook 3 to 4 minutes over medium heat and let it reduce into half. Once it is reduced into half and looking thick, then again give it a stir and then add the coriander leaves and they are done. This yellow peas curry is not only a healthy snacks idea as well as a perfect curry to go with most breads like roti, paratha or naan. Now switch up the flame. Usually street vendors serve this Ghugni Chaat in a small leaf bowl garnished with spoonful of green chili, coriander leaves, lime juice and soft onions. It's a very mouth-watering chaat. Try this recipe at your home and I'm sure you will love it. Thank you for watching this video and I'll see you soon with another video. Bye-bye, take care.